Welcome in the Organic Chemistry online lecture series. Today we are going to study about this point, that is pyranose form of the D-glucose. In previous few videos on the topic carbohydrates, I have explained in detail about the classification of carbohydrates and the open chain structures of the carbohydrates. Okay, so we will see now a further concept of this topic, and the most important concept here we have to see is that the pyranose form of the D-glucose. So first of all, I will draw here the structure of D-glucose, open chain structure of D-glucose. Always remember this structure, because every time we will require this structure now onward. So first of all, you have to draw CHO aldehyde group on the first carbon as a first carbon, and the last carbon will be CH2OH. Okay. So this is first carbon, this is six carbon, in between there will be four carbons. So I will draw four horizontal lines. Okay, so you remember that only carbon number third has a OH group on this side. All other OH groups are on this right hand side, remember. So in this way you can remember the structure of D-glucose. Okay. Now you have to complete the structure by placing here hydrogens. So this is the open chain structure of the D-glucose, remember. D-glucose, we called it as a open chain structure. Okay. Now if we give the numbering here, so this carbon will carry first number. This is second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Okay. So if we have to draw the pyranose form of the D-glucose, then there is a ring formation. Okay. So you know pyran can be represented like this. This is a pyran. So if six member ring is formed in this structure, then it is called as a pyran form of the D-glucose. Now we will see how the pyranose form of the D-glucose is obtained. So always remember that to obtain the pyranose form, to obtain the pyranose form of the D-glucose, of D-glucose, the hydroxyl group at C5 position, remember, hydroxyl group at C5 position. So here in this structure you will observe that this is the OH group, this is a hydroxyl group at C5 position, are involved in the ring formation. Hydroxyl group at C5 position is involved in the ring formation. Now how ring is obtained? Just remember that this hydroxy group carry a lone pair of electron, and this will attack on this carbonyl carbon of carbon number first. Okay, so I can say this OH will attack on this carbon, because this is electrophilic carbon, to form the ring form of this D-glucose. Now here there are two possibilities of forming the ring form. So I will write here. So either here is a formation of OH group. So this OH will be on right hand side, or it will be on left hand side. So depending upon that, there are two possibilities. So first possibility is this one, that OH group is on right hand side. Rest of the three groups I will draw here as it is, remember. So this is OH, H, OH as it is, H, OH, and H. Now here finally there will be CH2OH, but the hydroxy group of this 5 carbon is now represented in this way. Okay, so this will be the one form. Okay, and another form will be just this OH group will be on this side here. So OH group will be on this left hand side, CH. The rest of the structure is as it is. OH, H, OH. Here is hydrogen, OH and H. Rest of the structure is as it is. So CH to OH. And this fifth carbon hydroxy group will be represented like this. So now here, depending upon the position of this hydroxy group, you see this carbon is a new stereogenic center. Okay. So when this OH group is on right hand side, then it is called as alpha anomer. Remember, so it is called as alpha D glucopyranose. Okay, alpha D glucopyranose. And when this hydroxy group is on left hand side, then it is called as beta D glucopyranose. Okay, so first one is alpha D glucopyranose, second one is beta D glucopyranose. So all these two are the ring structure of this D glucose, ring form. So how ring form is obtained? Just remember that this carbonyl carbon is having number 1, this is having number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So if you have to obtain the pyranose form, so that is 6 membered cyclic ring containing oxygen. So if you have to obtain the such kind of ring for the glucose, then there should be reaction, or we can say this type of mechanism will be involved here. The hydroxy group which is present on fifth carbon will attack on this carbonyl carbon. So you can count the number of bonds in the ring. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the newly formed bond 6. So this ring is a 6 member ring. So here ring is not seen in a proper way in the open chain structure, that is Fischer projection. The ring is not seen in a proper way. But though you can consider it as a ring, because here there is a bond formed between this carbonyl carbon and this fifth carbon. Now here this carbon is a new stereogenic center. So remember that this carbon is known as a anomeric carbon. This is anomeric carbon because it forms two anomers. When the hydroxy group is on right hand side, then it is known as alpha form or alpha anomer. If the hydroxy group is on left hand side, then it is called as beta anomer. So the first one will be alpha D glucopyranose structure, and the second one will be beta D glucopyranose structure. I have drawn here once again the alpha D glucopyranose form and beta D glucopyranose form of the glucose. But by observing this structure, this is a Fischer projection, remember, this is a Fischer projection. By observing this structure, the ring form doesn't look good actually, because this is a stretchable bond between this carbon and oxygen. Here also this bond is not looking properly. So in Fischer projection formula, the ring form of the glucose, that is alpha D glucopyranose as well as beta D glucopyranose, is not represented properly. So that's why we need to draw the another form, and that another forms are called as Haworth formula and the chair conformation of this alpha D glucopyranose and beta D glucopyranose. So by observing this Fischer projection formula, we can draw its Haworth form. Okay, so how to draw the Haworth form from this Fischer projection formula, that we will see here. So before that, you just remember that if this hydroxy group is on right hand side on anomeric carbon, then it is called as alpha form or alpha anomer. If the OH group is on left hand side, then it is called as beta anomer or beta form, and this carbon is known as anomeric carbon because it is a stereogenic center. It has four different groups attached. So how to draw the Haworth form now, that we will see. So Haworth form of Haworth form. So this Haworth formula were discovered by the scientist Haworth. That's why they are called as Haworth form. So from the Fischer formula of the oxide ring structure looks defective because the 5 or 6 member ring is not properly represented by Fischer formula, as I said earlier. Further, there is unusually long bond between oxygen atom and C5O carbon atom, so it doesn't looks good. So that's why to rectify this anomalies, we have a Haworth formula by first drawing a proper 5 or 6 member ring. So how to draw the Haworth form, that I will explain. So first of all, draw a proper ring like this. Okay, so this is a proper ring. You have to draw the proper ring. So I will write 2 rings, one for this alpha D glucopyranose and another one is for beta D glucopyranose. Okay, now here there are 2 rings. I have explained once again. So I have drawn the proper 6 member ring first of all. One for alpha D glucopyranose and another for beta D glucopyranose. Now how to draw the Haworth form from this Fischer projection form, that I will explain. The groups which are on the right hand side in the Fischer projection formula are drawn below the ring. Remember, the groups which are on right hand side in this Fischer projection formula are drawn below the ring. Now first of all, see this alpha D glucopyranose. So we'll start from this structure. Now if we consider this as a anomeric carbon, okay, so this is anomeric carbon. So the groups which are on right hand side are drawn below, so write this OH group here below the plane. Then second carbon will be this, so I will draw here first a bond like this. Okay, now the groups which are on right hand side are below, so this OH will be also below the ring. Then there will be hydrogen, then there will be OH, and then there will be H here. So the groups which are on right hand side, we have to draw them below the plane, and the groups which are on left hand side, we have to draw them above the plane. So I will write here like this. Okay, so this is the Haworth form of this alpha D glucopyranose. Similarly, we can draw the Haworth form of this beta D glucopyranose. In the same way, we can draw here OH group will be on upper side, hydrogen will be lower side. So similarly, we can draw the for other carbons. Rest of the positions are as it is, like alpha form CH2OH. So this is beta D glucopyranose. So from this open chain Fischer projection, we can draw the Haworth form. So once again, I will explain. First of all, draw the proper ring, 6 member ring, and then the groups which are on right hand side of this Fischer projection formula are drawn below the plane, and the groups which are on left hand side are drawn above the plane. So this structure now looks proper rather than this Fischer projection formula. So this is all about the pyranose form of D glucose, how to represent it in Fischer projection formula and then in Haworth form. In another way, in chair form also we can represent this pyranose form, so that we will see in the next video. So in this video, this is sufficient. So for today, we will stop here and we'll meet in the next video with the chair form of this alpha D glucopyranose and beta D glucopyranose. So we'll stop here. Have a nice day. Thank you.